أكل لحم الجزور.
Also eating the meat of camel.
كذلك الردة لأنها محبطة لكل العمل. نسأل الله السلامة.
And also when a person he leaves Islam, then this leaving Islam, it invalidates all the actions, including wudu.
أما مس الذكر.
As for a person touching his private part.
فيرجح شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى.
And Sheikh Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said that his opinion was.
أنه غير ناقض لكن يستحب له الوضوء.
That a person touching his private part, this doesn't break a person's wudu. It invalidates a person's wudu. However, it's recommended for him to repeat his wudu.
نعم. طيب نبدأ بالتطبيق.
Okay, so now we start with the practical implementation of the wudu of the ablution. Somebody speaks in Arabic.
تعال أنت ما غير خلنا خلنا أي
واحد صغير
ما يضرب تعال سخن لأنك أنت الآن نعشت على الجدار لأن موضوعك واضح تعال من هنا من الأمام بسم الله طيب الآن عندنا إشكال وهذا من الشيطان وهو التبذير في استعمال الماء.
So now we have a common problem and this is from Shaitan and that is being wasteful of water. This is from Shaitan.
إسراف في استعمال الماء.
Being wasteful in performing ablution using water.
نعم فعندما يفتح الآن هذا المنفذ الذي يخرج منه الماء تجعله على أقل درجة. نعم.
So the Sheikh saying that when you, for example, open the tap from which water exits, then have it at the lowest level that's possible.
أتى بشروط الوضوء.
So now the brother has fulfilled the conditions of wudu.
الإسلام والعقل والتمييز والنية.
الإسلام, intellect. He's able to. He's at the age where he can distinguish. He has the intention that this is ablution.
وما ذكرنا.
And the other conditions that we have mentioned.
الآن يبدأ بالبسملة.
He begins by saying بسملة.
بسم الله.
Saying بسم الله.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا يغسل الكفين. الكفين. يغسل الكفين قبل البدء في الوضوء.
So now, before beginning his wudu, he washes his hands.
الى الرسم هذا مفصل الكف نعم.
So a person before he makes the wudu he washes his hands up to his wrist, up to his palm here.
فغسل الكفين قبل البدء في الوضوء من المستحبات سنة.
So therefore washing the hands before making wudu is from the mustahabbat, meaning it's from the recommended acts.
إلا في نوم الليل إذا استيقظ لصلاة الفجر أو إلى قيام الليل يجب عليه غسل الكفين ثلاث مرات قبل إدخالهما في الإناء.
And the only exception is if a person wakes up from sleeping at night, meaning deep sleep, then it's obligatory, it's wajib, it's an obligation upon him to wash his hands three times before he enters them into the utensil.
وإن لم يغسل فوضوءه صحيح.
However, if he doesn't wash his hands three times, then his wudu is correct.
لكن إذا كان عالما بالحكم فهو آثم.
But if he knows of the ruling and he doesn't do this on purpose, then he's sinful.
يسمي.
So he mentions the name of Allah by saying بسم الله.
وقبل هذا أتى بشروط الوضوء ومنها النية.
And of course, before this, he comes with the conditions of ablution, including the intention.
يغسل كفين ثلاثة.
He washes his hands to his wrists three times.
أو مرة واحدة.
Or even once.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا يأخذ حفنة من ماء بيده اليمنى.
And then after this, he takes a handful of water with his right hand.
يتمضمض بأن يدخل الماء في فيه.
And then he places the water into his mouth and rinses his mouth.
وكذلك في منخريه.
And at the same time, he rinses his nostrils.
ثم بعد هذا يمج الماء من فيه. ويستنثر بيده اليسرى بأن يخرج الماء من منخريه.
And then after this, after he's emptied his mouth into his nose and his after he's entered the water into his mouth and his nose, he then rinses his mouth and he spits out the water and he rinses the water from his nose with his left hand until the water's come out.
بغرفة واحدة.
And that is with one handful. That's done all at one time.
هذه السنة.
So this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
يسمي.
He says Bismillah. He mentions the name of Allah.
ثم يأخذ حفنة من ماء بيده اليمنى.
Then he takes one handful of water with his right hand.
يتمضمض ويستنشق ويستنثر بيده اليسرى.
And he rinses his mouth and his nostril, and then he exits the water with his left hand from his nose.
مرة أخرى يأخذ حفنة من ماء يتمضمض.
So another time he takes a handful of water with his right hand, and he places it in his mouth and his nostrils, his nose, and then he blows it out and spits out the water. And he uses his left hand when he's.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا يغسل الوجه.
And then after this, he washes his face.
فما هو حد الوجه؟
So therefore, what are the limits of the face? What is the face? What comes under being the face?
من منبت الشعر المعتاد إلى أسفل الذقن طولا.
So in terms of the length, then from the top of the head where hair normally grows, which is normal.
أو من منحنى الجبهة هنا من منحنى عندما تنحني الجبهة. نعم.
Or from the top of his forehead.
طيب.
Up until the bottom of his chin. So this is in terms of the length of his face. From where hair normally grows, the top of the forehead to the bottom of his chin in terms of length, and then from ear to ear in terms of width.
نعم. هل يجب عليه أن يخلل اللحية يعني يدخل الماء بين شعر اللحية أو يأخذ حفنة من ماء هكذا ويخلل ما بين الشعر؟
So is it obligatory for a person to separate each strand of hair with water and make sure like hair reaches and separates every single water? Or that, for example, a person takes a handful of water and make sure they enter into all of his beard?
هذا يرجع فيه إلى اللحية.
This, the ruling of this goes back to the type of beard he has, i.e. the amount of hair.
إذا كانت اللحية لحية خفيفة,
if a person has a beard which is very very light,
يرى الخد أسفل من اللحية. كما في لحية الأخ. نعم, كما في لحية الأخ. نعم. يرى الخد الآن أسفل من اللحية لأن اللحية خفيفة. فالتخليل في حق هذا واجب ولا بد.
So if a person's beard is very light, in the sense that you can see the cheeks of a person through his beard. So the hairs of his beard are a very, very little number. Then, if this is the type of beard, then it's an obligation for a person to make sure he separates the strands of his hair and his beard and he washes them.
وإذا كانت اللحية كثيفة مثل
And if, however,
التخليل مستحب.
If, however, the beard is heavy so that you can't see the skin which is under the beard, then separating the strands of the beard is something which is recommended, but it's not obligation. هذا لا يرجع إلى اللحية قصيرة.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا يعني بعد أن يغسل الآن الوجه. واستغسل من اللحية لأنه يحصل بما استغسل من اللحية المواجهة. نعم.
So now he's washing his face. And including in this is the beard. Whatever is dropping from the beard, that he washes this as well. Or he rinses it.
نعم, يغسل.
Meaning he places his wet hands over his beard as well.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا.
And after this.
يغسل اليد اليمنى.
He washes his right arm.
فما هو حد اليد؟
So therefore, what is the limit of being the right arm? What is the limit?
من أطراف الأصابع,
starting from the tips of the fingers,
إلى أن يشرع في العضد, يعني حتى يستوعب المرفقين من أطراف الأصابع. لا يكفي غسل الكفين في أول وضوء. غسل الكفين في أول وضوء سنة. وهنا فرض من فروض الوضوء أن يغسل من أطراف الأصابع حتى يشرع في العضد. مع المرفقين أي يعني استوعب المرفقين نعم.
So now the limits of the arm is to start from the fingertips. He starts from the fingertips and washes it all the way up until some of the elbows. He's washed the elbow as well. So the elbows are green being washing. The Sheikh mentioned that when we spoke about washing the hands before the wudu, then this is a recommended act. However, in the wudu, it's not enough for a person to start from his palm. No, he starts from his fingertips, and this is the obligation. From the fingertips all the way to and including the elbow.
نعم هل يشفع في العضد ويغسل العضد؟
So does a person even begin to wash some of his upper arm?
لا.
No, he doesn't wash his upper arm.
نعم. يبدأ باليمنى.
So he starts with his right hand.
ثم اليسرى.
And then his left hand.
ما هو الفرق بين غسل العضو ومسح العضو؟
So what is the difference between washing the limb or running wet hands over the limb?
سوف يأتي معنا يمسح الرأس ولا يغسل الرأس.
Because we're going to come to the fact that he does masḥ over the head, meaning he gets wet hands and he runs them over the head, not he doesn't wash it.
غسل العضو يتقاطر الماء يعني تساقط الماء الآن هذا غسل.
So the meaning of washing a limb is that after he's placed water over it, there's droplets of water which are dropping.
نعم إذا كان لا يتقاطر هذا مسح.
And if the limb is wet but there's no droplets which are dropping, then this isn't washing, this is just masḥ, wiping over with wetness.
نعم الآن يمسح الرأس يبدأ بمقدمة الرأس إلى قفاه ثم يعود مرة أخرى.
So now we're going, the next thing that he does is he wipes his, he runs his wet hands over his head. So he begins with the top or the beginning of his head and goes all the way to the back, and then he brings his hands back to the front.
نعم ويدخل سباحتين.
And he enters both of his wet index fingers
في صماخي أذنيه.
In the inside of his ears.
ويمسح بالإبهام ظاهرهما.
And as for the thumbs, then he uses them to wipe the outside of the ears.
مسح لا غسل.
And this is مسح, meaning using wet hands and running them over the head and not غسل, not washing. So droplets of water, they're not now dropping for him from there. It's just wet hands that he's using.
نعم. هل يمسح الرقبة؟
Should a person wipe his neck?
لا.
No.
هل يأخذ ماء جديد للأذنين؟
Does a person take new water for his ears?
لا.
No.
الآن يغسل الرجل اليمنى ثم اليسرى.
And now the next thing that he does is washes his right foot and then his left foot.
إذا كان على رجليه جوربين أو خفين كما عند الأخ.
If a person is wearing either خفين which are the leather ankle socks that go and include your ankle or normal socks, fabric socks,
فالسنة أن يمسح عليهما.
Then the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is that he does musk, meaning he just runs his wet hands over the sock or over the leather socks.
ولا يخلع.
And then he doesn't take them off.
لكن بشروط المسح الخفين.
But that is with the conditions of wiping over the khuf or the jorab, the socks or the leather socks.
الشرط الأول.
The first condition.
أن يكون قد لبس الجوربين على طهارة كاملة أي توضأ وضوء كامل وغسل الرجلين بالماء.
So the first condition is that when he wore the socks or when he wore the khuf, the leather socks that cover the ankles, that he only wore them after performing a full ablution, meaning he performed all of his wudu and he washed his feet and then he put his socks on or he put the khuf on, the leather socks. That's the first condition. And second thing is that the jorab tukun tahir.
نعم لا نجس.
And then the second condition is that the socks that he is wearing or the khuf, the leather socks he is wearing, that they themselves are clean and pure. They're not najis, they're not impure, they're not impurities on them.
ساترة لغالب العضو.
And that they cover most of the foot, they cover most of the limb.
يعني هذا الجورب الآن يظهر منه مثلا الكعبين.
So for example, some people they wear those, you know, those ankle socks or the sports socks.
فهل يصح المسح على هذا الجورب؟
So some people they wear ankle socks or sports socks that uncover some of the ankle.
نعم.
Is it therefore correct?
نعم، لأنه ساتر لغالب العضو.
So is it correct for a person to pray, is it correct for a person to perform musk, wipe over socks which cover the ankle? Yes, if it covers the ankle.
وأن يكون المسح في الحدث الأصغر للحدث الأكبر.
And then the last condition is that wiping over the socks or the leather socks, the fabric socks or the leather socks is done only in the minor impurity, not the major impurity.
لأن الحدث الأكبر موجب للاغتساء.
Because the major impurity, جنابه, this obligates a full ghusl.
الشرط الأخير.
And then the final condition is
أن يكون المسح في الوقت المحدد.
That the musk, the wiping over the leather socks or the fabric socks is done within the regulated time period.
يوم وليلة للمقيم.
And that is a day and a night for a person who is resident.
24 ساعة.
I 24 hours.